I did my best to notice when the call came down the line. Up to the platform of surrender, I was brought, but I was kind. And sometimes I get nervous when I see an open door. Close your eyes, clear your heart, cut the cord. Are we human, or are we dancer? My sign is vital, my hands are cold, and I'm on my knees looking for the answer. Are we human, or are we dancer?
Okay, so I've just walked around the deck after a rough night at sea, and we found three flying fish on deck. You can see the wings of this one, and they can reach pretty high spots because we're about 6 or 8 feet off the water, so it's pretty impressive.
John, we're in the day 6 or 7, I'd have to check my journal, but today and last night presented some uncomfortable conditions. Fortunately no one's been ill, but if you're going to be seasick, I think this would be the conditions to do it. We're expecting another 24, 36 hours of this, but even though it's a little bit uncomfortable, we're still having a great time. Looking forward to halfway. I think we're 3 days off the equator, which will be a bit of a celebration because we're two-thirds down, one
to go. So in terms of preparation, Liam and I made a schedule a month in advance to get ready for preparation in terms of just provisioning from the food side, because we had to prep for a month at sea. So even though the trip's only gonna be about 20 days, we wanted to prep for a little bit extra time. So we planned that once a week, every Monday, we would go and do a big shop. So we spent, I guess I did, Liam helped me a lot actually, but I spent a couple of days putting together a menu plan just to give us an idea of how much protein we would need, what kind of vegetables, starches, that kind of thing, dry goods. And then based on that menu plan, I put together lists of what we were going to shop for. So, you know, how many steaks we would need, how many pork loins, that kind of thing. And then every week we just went and focused on one thing. So 1 week we did only dry goods. Another week we just did proteins. And then obviously we did the fresh produce the very last day. So just the day before we left. And that's when we went to the fish market too and got some fresh fish. And it's been working out. We have lots of food. So we're definitely not going to go hungry.
They continue to film from outside the net.
Tell us about what we're looking forward here going forward next week.
We're about 1,000 miles off the coast of Mexico, so we're about one third of the way across. So it's definitely a long trip out at sea, crossing the world's biggest ocean, but it's been a lot of fun. We've had a few days of a little bit stronger winds with bigger seas, but over the next 3-4 days it looks like it's going to start to dissipate, and we'll probably see the seas get a little bit smaller here by Monday, and then probably by Tuesday, Wednesday, it looks like we're going to be entering the doldrums closer to the equator, where hopefully the wind dies right off for us.
John, we are just north of the equator, less than 1 degree, and actually less than 1 minute, and of latitude, and within about less than 5 minutes, we're going to cross into the southern hemisphere. And of course, anybody who has not done that by ship before is known as a polywog, and there's a special ceremony we have ready for the polywogs, and that'll be happening directly after we cross the equator. Shellbacks on board. So as King Neptune, we welcome you across the equator to the southern hemisphere. And we have an initiation. So as everyone, please take your phones and cameras. Thank you. Kelly, anything in the top? Lee?
Oh, no.
Okay. Yeah. Everyone's watch waterproof?
Very, very.
Can I have your hand, Liam?
Okay, polywogs!
Welcome
to the southern hemisphere!
Two, three!
As sure as night is dark and day is light, I keep you on my mind both day and night. And happiness I've known proves that it's right, because you're mine, I walk the line.
All right, everybody, this is a little bit of champagne and a little grog for everyone to celebrate two eventful things today. The first is Komokwa's passing across the equator. Some of us have been across the equator before, others haven't, so the polywogs here, people all wet, have been initiated. The boat has been initiated, and next we're going to slip down. We're at 1,000 nautical miles from our destination, so in less than a mile we'll be 999, which is the very last time we'll see four digits for a long time now. So congratulations, everybody. We managed to survive an engine, almost an engine room fire, expertly put out by our crew, and we survived Lee's cooking, which has really been, you know, challenging, Kelly's jokes, and they were really funny the first three times, don't you all agree?
Yes.
Yeah.
Well, it takes a while to get them right, you know what I mean?
There we go.
That's how you tell
them. Oops. Well, we had to christen the Komokwa.
That's right.
And then we've also We've also, all six of us have had to really suffer through the fact that there's only one couple on board. And I must say that there's been some weird sounds in the middle of the night that made me worry whether or not that's still a true statement.
I think Matt and Jason should keep it down.
Has everybody got
Let's stop this one up.
Does anybody not have champagne and want some?
Wait,
John,
for John
and Brian.
John, this is for you.
John, tell me what the weather's doing right now.
Well, the weather is blowing about 10 to 15. It's probably about to go up to 20 because we've got a squall coming across the front of the boat here and heavy rain's just starting. As you can see, windshield making the rain. And waves will probably build up a bit to maybe 3 meters, 9 feet. And pretty exciting.
Thanks, Joe.
This is Ruku Hiva in the Marquesa Islands, the most easterly of French Polynesian islands. And we've come here after traveling 15 days on the high seas. And we're very happy to be here. I'm really looking forward to our first trip.
Well, we're 3 hours off of our, not final destination, but our first port of call, land. And that's about 27 miles from where we are right now. And you're looking at me at my favorite spot for the whole trip, sitting up here and reading books.
Could you be love? away.
Careful of him.